In this video, let us understand how to make car showroom project. So this is a PHP project. The backend is MySQL and we are using the XAMPP server here. So therefore it is a PHP with backend MySQL and based on the XAMPP server. So now to work with, generally you require XAMPP server. XAMPP server has to be installed in your system. Now let us look at the project modules. It will have two major modules. One is a admin module. The other one is a customer module. Let us understand the overall design of the project. What are the things we'll cover in this? How it will serve the purpose? What are the things will be covered in this? So this is a car showroom. Basically, car showroom online. So therefore, customer can view the cars, what are the cars available in the showroom, and they could able to book the car. So here the car showroom, so we'll have multiple cars, so there are the different models. So assume that this is the model 1, this is the model 2, right? So this, in order to buy them, so customer has to walk into showroom and then need to buy. This is the regular method. Now what we can do is we can make it online. So therefore, once it's online, so people who are interested, they can access this website and from there they can able to view. So now it's virtual. So here is a customer. So what customer can do is they can sign up, then they can log in, they can view the models or they can view the cars, even they can get the quotations. So what is the price for the car, and based on that they can book the car. Now you can see that, so they don't need to come all the way to showroom to do all these activities. They can sit at their home, they can do all these activities. From the admin side, so again this is admin, our employee can log in here. So what they need to do, so again you say view car, so therefore you need to create all the cars. So first we create the model, what are the models are there here, and the list will be available, so therefore you can able to see the list. And next is the quotations, so what is the price for the each car, that details we need to enter. And the corresponding list we can able to see. Next one is customer list, where all the customers sign up, that customers we can see here. And the book car list, okay, what are the cars booked, car booked list, that will come here. So then they can log out from the system. So there's a logout option. Now these are the two main modules. One is this admin module and here is the customer module. And correspondingly for each main option there is a corresponding table. So there are three tables here, and then when you book the car there is another table. So you should communicate properly between the customer to admin. So therefore, what are the entries you have done here, it should reflect here, and what are the entries you have created, it should be reflected over here. That is what very important. So in this video we'll completely show you like the complete project demo. Also we'll show you like some code, how the code works, and you can able to download this project. We'll provide you the link, so therefore you can able to download this project. So this project will be useful for two category of people. One category for a student who are doing the course and they need to do a project. So if you need to do a project, probably this is a good project, so therefore you can choose this one. Otherwise you're looking for a job and you need an experience, therefore you can try this project your own, or you can download, you can work with that, modify this, add lot of things. So therefore understand the whole concept and then add the title in your resume. Therefore you, this will enhance your ability to answer the questions, therefore you get a good job. Therefore please try this, okay? Therefore it will, for both the category people, so it's really helpful. So as we told already, we are already providing option to download the projects. So therefore you can log into our website iBlix.com, then /download. So here you can able to download this project and subscribe to our channel. So your subscription definitely will help us to improve the quality. We'll bring you more videos, therefore you can get the benefit. And also if you see something to say, you want to say something to us, please write it in the comment box. And if you like the video, click the like button. Also, we have the videos like how to create and run the PHP first project. So here is the link. Even that link is available in the description. Please check and learn like how to start from the scratch, how to run the project, how to install the XAMPP server. All will be explained in this video. Because in a single video, to explain everything, to discuss everything is difficult. Therefore, please watch this video. Therefore, you'll get a complete idea. So this is another series, so from part 1 to part 10, So here you can learn the code step by step. So because we will write the code in front of you, therefore you can understand the whole concept. You know like how to write the code. That definitely will help you. There are totally 10 parts. So when you are free, watch them, and then also you can try your this project. You also, then you get a complete idea how to make this project. So therefore, if you work for each project, definitely your experience will increases. That you can encash in your job. Okay. Therefore, keep learn, keep improve yourself. Now I'll show the demo here, like how the whole project works. So let's look at the demo. So again, if you're not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe. So below the video, you can see the Typlix tutorials, and click on videos. Here you can see all the videos. So here you can see that a bank project PHP, how to do that, step by step explanation up to 10 videos. If you watch the 10 videos, then you get a clear picture how to build the PHP project, and also you can try this project. Definitely your own, you can able to write this project. So apart from this, we have many other projects too. So when you have time, please go through them and check out which other project you are interested. And you want to search anything. So for example, you want to write install XAMPP installation. So click here. So you can see that here is XAMPP installation. How to install the XAMPP, that is explained here. And after that, this is the first project video. How to install XAMPP and how to work with the first project. Because in each video, you'll get a one or other concept. Therefore, keep watch more videos, then gain the knowledge. Definitely, it'll be helpful for your interview as well as your academics. Fine. We'll move on. So you can see that XAMPP server is already running here. If you're not yet running, so just you have to go to control panel. And you have to start these two, so Apache and MySQL, both you have to start. After that, you can go to the browser. So here is the browser, and then if you type localhost, so at the end you can see there is a phpMyAdmin. You need to click on phpMyAdmin, and then you have to go to SQL, and in this folder, so this is the car showroom tables. Okay, the tables are provided over here. So table structure is there here. Okay, so you need to create all these tables. So you have to create the tables, you need to copy the table and then select SQL and then paste here, and then you have to click go. Okay, maybe some error here. Okay, so what it say that no database selected, because you need to select the database. So click on card database. Then you have to select, because you can check here which database is selected, then paste, then you have to click the go button, right? So you have to execute each one. Okay, each line you need to execute here. First you need to execute this one, copy and paste here and click go. Next this one, next this one. Later you need to create the rest of them. Even you can create all the three at a one stretch also. So these four I want to create it in single stretch, therefore copy them, paste here, and then click go. If there are no errors, everything will be created. And now you can see that we have totally 6 tables in this project. Totally 6 tables. This is the one step. So next step is, in order to start the project, so you need to copy the folder name. So this is the folder name. It must be in htdocs only. So this is c:\xampp/htdocs. So therefore you need to copy the folder. Then you have to go to localhost, then /, and paste the address. Then click continue. Now you can see that there is admin login and there is a customer login. Now first we go to admin login. Now for admin, we already inserted a record with admin and then admin. So therefore you need to use the same credentials here. So admin, then admin. Okay, there is some problem. Let me rectify this. Fine. So check out this admin login table. This admin. So let me log in again. So this is admin, then admin. So submit. So now you can see that it's come to admin main page. So you can put some picture on the top, admin main page, indicating that this is admin main page. So that is possible. But anyway, what are the options is given here? Let me check first. So here's the model list. What are the list is there? That list has to come. So here you can go to model. So what is the model name? So you need to take the which model it is. Okay, I'll take Maruti here. So this is Maruti 800. Okay, we start with 800. So this is the detail. This is a basic model car. So when you click submit, it should be saved. Now if you go on list, so the list will come, and also you can check it out in the SQL server. Here you can see that model. So here Maruti 800, it's transferred to the SQL server. this is one step. Next one is the vehicle details. So here you need to write the individual detail. So let's say Maruti 800 XL. This is Maruti 800. In Maruti itself, you have XL, VXL, all is there. So therefore, you need to write about this. So this is XL series, which have power windows. So check out what are the features are there in this Maruti website, and then you need to write specifications. So what is this engine specification, other specification, you need to write in the specification. Price, what is the price? So it's 3,25,000 rupees, so that we can write here. Fine. So okay, you have to collect the complete data, and then we need to fill all the data here, and then you have to click save. Now the record is saved. If you go to admin main, so vehicle list, you can see the vehicle list here. The list will come. Next is the quotation price. What is the quotation price for this? So now you need to write vehicle price. So it's 2,80,000 rupees. Road tax, some 25,000 rupees. Insurance, 10,000 rupees. Some registrations rather, 10,000. So put together is the 3,25,000 rupees. So quotation price list, so it will show the price list here. Now we can copy the same address, localhost and the folder name, and we can go to one more tab, enter here, and they can click continue. So it is a customer sign up, because first time you need to sign up, you need to go to sign up page, and here you take the what ID you want. So let's say Arun, and the password, and you have to retype the password again. So this is Arun. And then address, and write the address, mobile number, and then email ID. So we have validation for everything, and also in this video we already explained like how you can make the validations. Okay, so completely it explained here, so therefore please watch this video if you want to make the validations your own. Right, so submit, so done. So now we can able to log in. So this is Arun with the password, submit. Okay. So okay, there is a SQL problem. So therefore now you can see Arun, then the password, submit. Okay, fine. So here is the vehicle list. What are the vehicles available in Maruti? That list is there. Then the quotations. So you can get the quotation for the same. So here will show the quotations. So probably the total is not shown. So you maybe try this, how to get the total. So here is the total, and there is one more text box is required, and then you need to calculate. Okay. So assume that it like assignment, and then try it out. So if you try and if you get the result, really good. That's how you can learn one by one. Next is a book car. So here, if the customer book the car, it should be reflect in the admin. So that is a challenging. So therefore, let's go, and you can see that different cars names will come. So therefore, you can choose the car. Then total amount, everything will come over here, and you need to make the advance payment here. How do you do that? This is a dummy payment. So you can specify that how do you do the payment. So you can see that paid. Paid using CAN card, then you can write the transaction number, then click next. So the car is booked from the customer side. Now go to admin. So here you can see register user list. There is one error. Okay, so here is the problem. So this is a MySQL query. So this is the old this thing. So the new one is connection query SQL. So therefore what we can do is we can say this is SQL, so variable, and then we can pass this string to SQL. Fine. Now this is the string, this is the statement which has to be executed, that will go to SQL. SQL is a variable, the connection string, and now you execute the query in a connection object. So once it's executed, the it will go to result. Now from the result you need to fetch row, and then you have to transfer to row. From the row you need to display it. Okay, so I'll just explain the code once this over. Now we can refresh this. So now we can see that Arun, the list will come, customer list will come. Now car list. Okay, so here is Arun, and which car he booked, that details are there here. Therefore this customer booked the car, so that's what you can understand. So this is the a small amount of data we have collected, but in real time you need to collect the more data. So therefore you need to elaborate. At least when you try, you need to try with the basic project. So for this serve the purpose, indicating that this particular user is purchased the car. Now if you check this tables, so now you can say booking table, you can see that number is generated automatically. We have the date, what date you booked, and here is the name, and is the vehicle, what is the amount paid, and all the details are there here. So this is what very important. You from the page, like from the browser, when you enter the data should go to the table. From the table again you need to fetch, and then you have to display it on the screen. So this is the challenge. Once you understand this, once you master it, then number of columns doesn't matter. Okay, it may be a 3, it may be 5, it may be 100. So the concept is almost same, sending to the table and then from there you need to fetch it back. So that is the concept actually, right? So therefore this is what very important when you do the project. Fine. So now what we can do is we'll understand some code here. So important one, I check to admin login. So here is the admin login. So here you can see username and the corresponding text. So this is the input text. Text1 is equal to empty. That means text one empty. So that means when you say admin login, admin main, and then log out, when you click again, you click admin. So there's the text box one and this is the text box two. So this is the code actually which is written, text box one and text box two, and this is the login button. So here is the login submit button. So this is the one actually. So when you submit, again it take to admin main page. Therefore now you need to go to admin main page. So this is the page. So here what it has to do, so here you can see session start, include head file, then include config file. So there is one more cut of the config file. So if I go to config file basically to SQL connection. So here there are four parameters. So one is host name, localhost, but that means in the same system, and the user root, password, because when install XAMPP server there is no password, there is empty, and this is the database name, car database. This is the database name, and here you need to use new MySQL I, and these are the parameters you need to pass to connection. So therefore next time wherever you say connection means that it should connect to car database, right? So this is what the config.php. then here is the dollar server request method is equal to post. That means when you submit the page, we can able to read the text one value and text two value. We can pass those to these two variables. From that we'll check in this particular database, and this particular table database is car database, and in that login admin login table, in that we need to check whether the entered user ID and the password is present or not. So if num rows greater than 0 means if there is a record, means what, this user and password is present, therefore we can take to next page. So this is the next page, so it will go to next page. And also we are using the session variable here, admin user, we are passing through this variable. So if you use the session variable, you need to say session start in the beginning, otherwise it will not be identified. Fine. So next it go to admin main page. So here is admin main page. Here is only links actually, so therefore all the links will be there here. So when you click model, it take to admin model. So here is the admin model. Fine. So here also you can see this is the design. This is a complete design. So model name and the details. And when you submit this, you'll take to the same page. And here is the code for the same. So here we need to insert this. Therefore, we return this particular code. So here you can insert the record. So next one is to list. So here is the list, okay, model list. When you click model list, the list has to come. So this is the admin model list. So if you go to admin model list, this is the file. So edit in Notepad++. So here what you need to do is we need to write a select query, select star from model tab, order by model name. This data that will be executed in the connection, the query will be executed, and whatever the data comes will go to the result variable. So this is the result variable. From that variable you need to read each row, fetch row. That means if there are 5 rows, each time one row will be fetched, and that data will be displayed here. So again it'll go to next line here, again it'll display it, again it'll go like that. So like that, the two things, one is to insert, you need to write an insert statement. To list the data, you need to use the select statement. So that's how throughout the project you need to write. So therefore keep try, and also watch these videos. So therefore they definitely will help you because here it's totally explained step by step. Insist that, so watch once, therefore parallel you can try, you can always learn this. Okay, thank you. So here is a subscribe button, please subscribe. And also if you have any other project requirement, please contact us. The address is available in our website. Please go to our website and check it out, all the details. Okay, thank you very much.